Hey guys, and welcome back! Very first episode, season 3. I'm Gander.
I'm Sopes.
And May Contain is brought to you today by
The Odd Leaf.
That's right, theoddleaf.com. Now, these guys are great. They do small blogs, quick reviews, and the thing that I love about them, they don't focus on mainstream topics.
No, they cover everything from, they cover the mainstream games as well, but also the board games that people have never heard of.
Yes.
All this extra stuff as well. So, and it's a great read. It's written really well.
It's good because it's not always just saying, this is what's amazing about the game. It is their point of view, not the reviewers, not everyone else. These are local guys, so support them, okay? Head over to theoddleaf.com. Now,
we're back. That's it. We're in the containment cage.
Do you like it, guys? This is it. This is it behind us here on the video. We've got our jumper up. We've got the merchandise wearing.
That's it. Yes, these shirts finally just came.
I've got the old shirt on.
Where's your
unfortunately,
shirt?
Look, this is what pisses me off with Australia Post.
Right.
Okay. I ordered my t-shirt before you.
That's true.
About 5 hours before you.
Yes.
You've got yours.
Yeah, I got mine
both of them.
Yesterday.
Why the hell? Now, I want to swear. Why the fuck have I not got mine?
I can't answer that.
Yeah.
I'm just happy I've got mine.
Someone put some powder in with my t-shirt. So, is it somewhere in customs?
I don't know. It's too offensive. It's not coming through.
I want it.
So
next video, 45-minute one, I'll be wearing it.
We'll see. But we are in the containment cage. We are back for season 3, like we said. Everything is growing.
Yes.
But the big question is, where have we been?
I don't know. Now, I've had a lot of personal life changes.
Yeah, well, it's been... We missed...
2 months.
For the show, yeah, we missed... Yep. As we said, we missed Christmas.
Yep.
Missed New Year.
Yep.
And we missed all of January. We're in February now.
Yep.
So, what have we been doing?
Guys, I hope you're sitting down. I hope you're ready. I have left EB Games.
It's true.
I've moved on from EB Games. It was sad. It was emotional. But I am now at Officeworks. And I'm loving it. It's a completely different change for me. I'm not saying I didn't dislike EB Games. It's just a change. A change is like a holiday. That's what they say. So,
well, pretty much they always say, if you enjoy what you're doing, then you never work a day in your life.
Exactly right.
And are you enjoying what you're doing?
I'm not working.
Exactly. So, and it's the same.
That's bad. If you're from Officeworks and watching, I am actually working, first of all. I'm doing quite a lot. But yeah.
I think one thing we need to mention as well is obviously the video feed.
Yes.
Right? Yep. For those who are still just listening to the podcast on Podomatic, right? We are still doing that. That we are a podcast.
Yeah.
But as you can see, Gander here is enjoying the camera way too much. I am getting used to it. I am enjoying it.
Yeah.
But yeah, this is what it's all going to be about now. This is season 3. We're back in
big. We're going big.
So that's why, and this is half the reason why we've been gone as well. We've been working on the show.
Yeah.
We've had. What, two months.
Get
all this right, and we did absolutely nothing.
So in the last, we did all this in the last week.
Yeah, we did
pretty
all this
much.
In the last week to go, well, we've got to get back on our feet and start doing all this again.
There's something really cool that is coming that we haven't mentioned as of yet. We didn't even mention it on our preview quick 2 minute thing.
Mm-hmm.
Is guys, we're actually going to have a third member.
That's true.
We're not going to introduce him just yet. We're going to keep a big question mark popping up on the screen of, who is this person? Where's the full team?
That's it.
But the third member will be doing game reviews.
Yes.
That's right, guys. Game reviews. May Contain, game reviews.
So May Contain is just, it's growing.
Yes.
The family is getting bigger.
This we're like a little tree.
Yeah. So what's going to happen is it's just going to keep growing from here. So
yep.
We'll still have just, Sopes and Gander. We're doing our podcast.
That's right.
Right? We may have guests coming up. We don't know. Like, anything could happen.
I know what he's referring to.
But we'll keep that.
We'll keep that under wraps. Let's just say pretty big celebrity.
Let's turn it back.
Yeah, okay. Just a local kid around the corner.
We'll see. But the family is growing and stuff like that. We're hoping to open up May Contain into more shoots and stuff
that. Yeah, yeah,
so yeah, it is. It's May Contain. It may contain anything.
Anything you want. But what have you been doing?
Me?
Yeah.
I've been getting into car accidents.
What?
Yeah, that's
true. Do you mean? What, as in you physically hit someone? Were you the cause of the accident?
Well, this story, right? I've been doing more than just getting into car accidents.
Okay, that's good.
Right?
Because it could be weird otherwise.
It has just been, a normal way of life for me and stuff like that.
Just continuing on.
Yeah, but this one, driving into work, minding my own business.
Just going along.
And then all of a sudden, I pull up at the lights.
Yeah.
And bang, right in the back.
Jesus.
I know. Shock? Right? Shock. I'm fine. It's a bit of a
shakeout.
What
was your immediate reaction when happened?
I'm being abducted. No.
aliens!
But no, got hit from the first car accident ever.
Oh.
Right? Shunted forward over the line.
Yeah.
What's happening? Right? Yeah. And literally, so like, got out, panicked.
Yeah.
Looked at the car and stuff like that. I'm yeah. like, all right, cool. No damage to mine.
Yeah.
Looked
yeah.
at their car. No real damage to theirs. Yeah. The guy gets out. He's in a suit and stuff yeah. like that. I'm like, oh, okay. No worries.
In his suit, yeah.
Yeah. And I'm like, he's like, you're all right. You're all right.
Just been hit by Will Smith from Men in Black.
I know. But then before it even dawned on me.
Yeah.
Right. I realized one thing.
What?
I'd been in a car accident.
Yeah.
And the way it had played out, car accident, two cars involved.
Yeah.
Three people involved.
Yes.
One dead.
What?
And no damage to either car.
You, the person plowing into you, died.
Not necessarily.
Okay. I'm trying to work this out now.
I was actually hit.
Yeah.
By a hearse.
No way.
My first car accident. And I've been hit by a hearse.
This is just your luck.
With a body in car.
Did right? it pop out? Did anything happen? No, it was just...
Nothing like that.
I've seen those things on the channels where the coffin rolls out and then the guy gets out and runs down the street.
It's kind of almost like Will Smith, not in Men in Black, but in Bad Boys 2, where they got all the bodies flying out the back of the
it
car.
It was like that.
No.
No. it is in my head.
But the first thing that went through my mind is I just went into panic mode, right? I'm like, well, what normally follows a hearse? You know, maybe 6,000 cars.
Right? Do they? Is that what happens when you normally leave?
What happens in the movies.
Okay, okay.
I've seen it happen.
Yeah.
But it's one of those things that I'm just sort of like, well, you know, where's all these people?
What's happening?
And then it dawned on me after that. I'm like, well, it doesn't matter if that they're doing it. There's other cars on the road. And when they look at a car accident, you ever drive past a car accident and you're like, you know it, some things are going to be horrible. But you can't look away.
Yeah.
You start looking around, you're like, this is incredible.
Yeah.
This is amazing.
What's happening?
Right? I know lives have been maybe lost here.
Was it... May I ask?
Yes.
Was he on the way to the funeral?
See, that part's unconfirmed. I didn't get these details because I'm still taking in that I was in a car accident.
Yeah.
Right? So I'm still shaking from the actual crash.
Yeah, yeah.
But then what ended up happening after that was... It was like literally I'm looking at all these cars driving past and they don't look at it like it's a normal car accident anymore.
No.
They look
no.
like, yeah, it's a car accident with a hearse.
Yeah, because it's different.
It is very different.
Yeah.
But anyway, like, the way it sort of came to terms with the guy's like, are you all right? You're all right? Yep. No damage to either car.
He's still dead. Yes.
Yeah,
continue on.
That's it. Pretty much exactly how the conversation finished. I'm like, we're still alive, right? Everyone that was still alive is still alive. Everyone that is dead is still dead. So let's just move on from here.
What's weird is when you think about it is, let's say that they've done the funeral already.
Yes.
He's now driving into his cremation grave, like to get burnt or just to get put into the 6 feet under.
Right.
The last thing in that poor man's life was hearing you.
I don't think he would have heard me.
Well, he could have.
The first thing went through my mind actually when I got back in the car to go to work, and I'm looking in the rear vision mirror going like,
should I go to the funeral? should I know more about this guy?
Well, it wasn't just that. I'm just thinking, this is literally going to be the first guy that is late to his own funeral. I'm like, I've heard the same, and they're like, and then the puns just kept rolling in. Just kept coming from there.
Wow.
But that was the one big thing that happened to me and stuff like that.
That's, yeah.
Other than that, from moving jobs and stuff like that, no, not for me.
Not for you.
I've renovated parts of the house still.
That's right. You've been doing extra rooms turning in cinemas.
Oh, I've been painting and doing everything like that. We'll have to take a tour or do a Let's Play went around there sometimes, stuff like
definitely.
That. So, but yeah, I've been doing a lot of painting and rebuilding of a house, so...
It doesn't sound exciting.
No, but it's kept me busy and it's kept me away from the show, so...
Yeah.
And this is things that, we've missed out on so much.
Well, the last episode, we didn't even have the new Batman vs. Superman trailer.
No.
We only had the teaser. So, there's the Batman vs. Superman trailer, the big trailer's landed, which we'll talk about soon. Deadpool was... Officially, the second trailer came out. I don't even know if the first one had already...
Yeah, and on that note...
Yeah.
I've seen it.
Yeah. That, it kind of annoys me that you've seen it, and I haven't, but I know you're not going to give anything away, because I'll strangle you. I would strangle you, and then we'll have that whole hearse incident again.
We'll have the whole murder recorded. Yeah, that's it.
So
the joys of a video feed now.
Okay, just quickly, so we can get it out of the way, and we're not going to talk about it. You liked it, you didn't like it.
I'm not going to say anything.
Good. He's a good guy.
I've seen it.
Yeah.
Not saying anything.
And Ryan Reynolds.
He's in it.
Good. Okay, so we're not talking about Deadpool. What other trailer? Wonder Woman. We've seen a teaser for it now. It's not even a proper trailer.
It's not really a teaser trailer. It was more of Kevin Smith in the background talking over the top of minor scenes that had happened.
But it still looked good. You have to admit, that got you excited.
It's good to see Wonder Woman on screen. It felt no different to me than seeing her in the trailer for...
this Batman suit where like, she cool. stood up. Like, she cool. with you.
Yeah. I've seen her. She's great. Like,
yeah.
I want to see more of a story trailer. I want to see... I haven't given much away at all yet, so I want to see more of what's going on.
Yeah.
But yeah, obviously we haven't talked about, obviously...
New X-Men trailer?
Well, not even just the trailer. A new X-Men trailer and stuff like that. There are films that have come out that we have not spoken about. We haven't spoken about Star Wars.
Yes.
Right? We haven't spoken about those other films that came out.
Like?
The Revenant.
I have not even seen The Revenant. I've seen Hateful Eight.
So that's another one I haven't seen. Yeah. See, we've got all these things to cover that we've got to catch up on that all have to be mentioned.
Okay. Let's not even continue. Let's quickly delve into some topics, spoiler-free, because we still don't want to ruin it.
Of course.
Let's talk about Star Wars, because I know you've been itching to talk about Star Wars.
Yeah, this is...
I'm excited.
This is something like we've both seen Star Wars.
Yeah.
How many times have you seen it now?
I've only seen it once.
I had to see it twice.
You've seen it twice.
Right.
Money bags.
I went opening night.
Yes.
I'm like, yep. Gonna see it at
three. That would have been good atmosphere.
It's a good atmosphere because everyone's in costume, everyone loved it and stuff like that, right? Long story short, I don't like it. I do not like Star Wars The Force Awakens.
And you know why that annoys me?
Force Awakens.
It frustrates me that I honestly feel, now this is my belief, don't try and change it, that you are saying you don't like it because you want to be that one person that doesn't like it.
I'm not the only person.
But the reasons you don't like it are null and void.
No, they're not.
You
they are literally... Like, okay, you know, I'm not even going to go spoiler-free on this anymore, right? This is crap, right?
The movie's crap.
This is absolute crap, and it's so unoriginal, right? Do you know what? I own The Force Awakens. I bought it in a freaking box set, and they called it Episode 4. So everyone has seen the film now. I don't have to cover anything up.
It was. You didn't like it.
It's the same. It's A New Hope.
Okay.
It is A New Hope, and all it actually is, is you have maybe the first three parts of the film is new content.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
And then
everything feels the same.
Yeah.
Okay. Like, so much. So you said it's crap. You didn't like it.
It's unoriginal. It doesn't.
It's unoriginal.
What they
could have
done, right? Everyone's like, they don't have to keep it with the Skywalker family. I don't care if they keep it with the Skywalker family. Keep it with the Skywalker family if you want it. They are an interesting story arc, right? But when there is literally a guy in the movie, when they show the first Death Star, they're like, it's three times bigger. And literally, someone stands at the table and goes, another Death Star? Yeah. Everyone in the audience is going, another Death Star? We saw it on the poster.
Yes. Right?
Yeah, great. It's three times the size. They destroy it in half the time. They ever destroyed the Death Star in the originals.
You knew this going into it.
No, I didn't.
You saw enough of the trailer to realize it was another Death Star.
Yeah, right? Death Star should have lasted three films.
No, it shouldn't.
It's Star Killer Base. If you want to make things bigger, make it last longer.
Yeah, but then kill it in half the time. All these three films, you would boycott and say that they're all the same part. It felt all too similar.
Yeah, so don't hype a movie like Star Wars. Because if you're going to watch it in chronological order now, right?
Yeah.
You can watch four films, including Empire, which doesn't have the Death Star, right?
Yeah.
But you can watch A New Hope, skip Empire, go Return of the Jedi, then Force Awakens. All have Death Stars.
And it would be all amazing. Because guess what, guys? Star Wars is amazing. The Death Star is a big part of the Star Wars franchise, and I fucking loved it. And you know what annoys me more? You hated it so much. You swear by it. It was crap. You hated it. You went and saw it twice, man, so you couldn't have disliked it that much. You went and saw it again.
I had to see it a second time.
Yeah.
And I went in with a different frame of mind.
Like, as in what? A crapper frame of mind?
I knew what I was getting into, right?
Yeah.
The second time round. Right? So I'm like, all right, no worries. Yeah. Great. So I knew what I was going to be watching.
Yes, and did you enjoy it more the second time?
I did enjoy it. I enjoyed it more the second time. But this is the same thing. It's like, well, what if they put a tumbling ball in every single Indiana Jones movie they made?
It would be,
the ball is in, you know, it's iconic to the film. Let's put it in every single film.
But no! It's set so long after. I understand the chronological order, and if you watch them straight after each other. How many years has this been since that original Star Wars?
It's like 30 years, whatever it is.
Okay, so they've kept the formula so much the same.
Yeah.
Yet, what's the one thing you didn't like? You hate it when they change it too much from the original story as well.
No. Do you know what? I like stuff like that, right?
Yeah.
You can, like, when they can change something, they can ruin it. But I'm not going to be like, okay, I'm going to hate that
straight
away.
I thought you weren't excited about Ghostbusters because it's a female cast.
No, and that's a different change, right?
Yeah.
I feel that when that Ghostbusters comes out,
yeah,
it's going to be literally like... And don't get me wrong, I love Kristen Wiig and Melissa McCarthy.
The females in that movie are phenomenal.
Right, but the way I reckon they're going to get utilized, it's like, oh, I've fallen over with my proton pack. And I'm like, ha ha! Like, I'm not going to friggin' enjoy it.
First of all, it's going to be set in the same universe because Bill Murray's in it.
Is that confirmed?
Well, Bill Murray is confirmed in it as a cameo. It's not confirmed that he'll be the same character that he played, but if you're getting him in there, why wouldn't you use him as the same character?
If you're going to use him as a different character, not the same universe. Simple as that. If he's in there and he's not the same character...
It's the same universe.
No.
If he's not the same character, it has to be a different universe.
Yeah.
I agree.
Yeah.
Sorry, I thought I misheard you. But yeah, if he's in there and he is the same character, it could be, well, his daughter. It could be someone who's, you know, a younger sister's taken over.
Again, now this is something that, like, I feel that Star Wars failed on as well.
What? Right? Oh, here we go.
Right. No, this isn't over.
No, okay.
Right? The characters that they brought back, right?
Yeah.
Great to see them on the big screen again, right?
Yes.
Love Mark Hamill, Harrison Ford, adore Carrie Fisher.
Yeah.
Right?
Really?
Yeah.
Okay.
I got a kiss from her, right?
Right here. Right there?
Yeah, met her at a con.
You get kisses from everyone.
I know.
Yeah.
But you know what?
What?
Completely underutilized, right? I reckon Harrison Ford is the only one that felt useful in the entire film. And when he rocked up, it felt, yeah, cool, that makes a lot of sense. Great.
He's in the film. What about his pal Chewie?
Yep, great.
That's a duo. Okay.
But then, like, the ending of the film, right, and everyone knows the ending of the film now, and friggin', like, Luke turns around and gets all teary-eyed and stuff like that, doesn't say a line of dialogue in the film.
Doesn't need to.
So it holds everyone in suspense.
They said so much by not saying anything.
But you know what? They didn't need that. All they need to do, right, they could have ended the film on, there's the map. We've completed the map. We know where he is. Next one, they rock up. Then they can do some, like, they might not find until half the film or whatever. They don't need him at the end of the film like that. Doing that.
Well,
like, what he did. He didn't do anything at all. And, like, again, like, I love the characters. I love how he looked and stuff like that.
See, to me, that it excites me for the next one. I'm pumped. I want to see Mark Hamill with a lightsaber running around.
Like,
just kicking ass.
Fantastic, right? But do you know what that makes this film then? It's a bridge film. That's all it is. They have, like... It's a stepping stone. It's a multi-billion dollar... Well, not billion. Million dollar, right? Yeah. Stepping stone.
That's fine. It was, mate, what's the average review? It has to be 90-something%.
Yeah, okay.
Everyone seemed to enjoy it. These are the critics, the head nogs. I still enjoy it. You're entitled to your own opinion. I'm not going to ever try to change you.
There are a lot of things I do like about the film.
Sounds amazing. Music's amazing.
Yes.
The acting is actually good. Like, they are brilliant. Because when they first did it, let's face it, they were unknowns and the acting was very kind of wooden.
One thing I do want to, I guess in a sense, an honourable mention, right?
Yeah.
To Adam Driver as Kylo Ren.
Yeah.
Right? I saw the film the first time.
Yeah.
I'm like, great, we've just got another whiny villain. He's not a Sith, right?
Yeah.
He's just a whiny villain,
right?
And then when I thought about it a little bit more and saw it the second time, I actually really liked what he'd become.
Okay.
Or what he is. He's the first real Star Wars villain that we've had who has no focused motive. He does have motive.
He has motive.
But not focused motive because he's so unhinged. I just feel that he's the first crazy villain that they've had.
He's not fully trained. That's
no,
what.
And it's not. And he's not fully...
And he's got layers, but let's not give away more than we have to, just in case you're one of those. You must be like a 1% that haven't seen it yet.
No, it's one of those things. If you haven't seen it now,
yeah,
that's on you, right? Okay. Seriously, the film came out in December.
Yeah.
Right? It's February now.
Yeah. Some people wait for Blu-ray. No, people do.
If you're a Star Wars fan, you would have seen it.
Okay.
Right? And when Kylo Ren starts losing it and stuff like that and starts smashing the friggin' like control panel and stuff like that with his lightsaber.
It's cool. It's cool to see.
First time I saw it, I'm like, oh, great, another, he's just whining. But no, he's unhinged. I get it. Yeah. So that's cool. Like, but I have a lot of issues with the film.
I understand.
Not saying I am not hyped for the next one, right?
So which they've already delayed.
Yeah, but do you know what? I didn't know that when they said, oh, it's not coming out until the end of the year of like 2018 now, I'm like, I thought it was going to be that anyway.
Yeah, yeah.
So when they said they delayed it, I'm like,
it wasn't. Yeah.
I thought it was coming out. I thought it was going to be like a Star Wars film for the end of every year.
Yeah. No. So, well, they're doing that, but it's not the same Star Wars movie.
Yeah. Yeah. So. Now, another thing I just want to touch on as well, right? Obviously, because Star Wars films coming out. Star Wars,
yeah.
Have you heard that Rogue One might be the first Star Wars film to receive an R rating?
No, I haven't heard that. I highly doubt that. It's Disney.
Yeah, that's what I thought as well. I
highly doubt that.
But apparently it got mentioned at some panel, right?
It's not true.
Because everyone was talking about it.
I can confirm that now, guys. It's not true.
And it won't be happening.
It won't happen.
But the idea of it is interesting.
It's cool, but it won't ever happen. They would boycott half their fans.
Yeah, exactly.
Well, three quarters of the fans.
And that's exactly what we were saying as well. The kids that have been now brought into the Star Wars things and stuff like that, great, because that's what they've got.
Yeah.
But, like, to bring an R rating into it now?
Yeah.
Yeah,
it's what do you guys think? Let us know. Get on the Twitter at @may_contain.
Yes.
Let us know what you think. Okay, let's just talk about the lineup of movies that are coming out.
Oh, see, I'm going to rage a bit more here. I have so much rage in me from everything that's come out.
Just okay, so you saw an earlier thing, but Deadpool's Valentine's Day, it's around the corner.
Deadpool, not going to say anything.
Yeah.
It's what you expect it to be.
Sweet. Man of Steel, well, Batman vs. Superman, Supers vs. Batman.
Yeah, so they released the whole film. They released the whole film in 3 minutes. Good on you, idiots. I
loved the trailer.
Yeah, I did.
I thought it was brilliant.
Until they released the freaking Battletoad at the end. Yeah, so one of the Battletoads rock up, he's like, "Ey!" And then like he just blows up, and I'm like, wow. So do you know what? The whole title to your film now is completely irrelevant. There is no freaking Batman versus Superman because they're going to work together at the end. We knew this already.
No,
right?
We did. Well, yeah, you had to have been an absolute idiot to think that they're not going to come together.
Yeah, of course, right?
Okay.
And it's called Dawn of Justice.
Yeah. So they have to come together. This is the catalyst. But you know what? They didn't show. They didn't show that. This like the Battletoad you so love to talk about it, Armageddon, whatever. He won't be the main villain.
I mean,
friggin', what's his name?
Who's the Supes fan here?
Fucking, yeah, I don't know.
Doomsday.
Doomsday.
Thank you.
He is not the main villain of that movie.
And who do you think's gonna be?
It will be Lex.
Now, apparently, this is another thing as
He'll
well,
be Lex,
right?
Yeah.
Apparently, the Lex in the film,
yes.
Jesse Eisenberg, is Lex Jr.
That's not true.
Now, that makes a lot of sense.
No, it doesn't. It makes no sense.
He's the right age.
No. No, he's shaved his head for the role.
Doesn't mean he can be the same. Like, I just want to be like Papa.
No, like, that would be stupid.
And this is one of those things of just taking something that you did did know
yeah.
and making it into something else and not liking it.
No.
If they did do that, I like it.
This is taking a rumour and then running with it, which is not going to be true.
This is like the Jason Todd rumour for Suicide Squad.
Well, yes and no.
And that's a brilliant rumour.
Where did you hear this rumour about him being Lex Jr.?
Oh, this is just things you read online.
Yeah, but there was a reason for it, because he's too
young for the role.
Too young for the role, yeah.
And you've got a very mature Batman,
yeah,
right? A very developed Superman and stuff like that.
Yes.
Everyone's of age. If, which, a big if,
yeah.
The Robin, the Jason Todd,
the Joker theory is true. Yeah, yeah. It'd be
perfect,
good. It would be good.
Age. Yep. Makes so much sense, right? To have a young Lex, why?
No, he, by the end of Dawn of Justice,
he'll change him.
He will be the Lex that you know, so that when they do all these little one-off movies, like, you know, they all have their own spin-offs, the Wonder Woman standalone, there'll be a Flash standalone, there'll be an Aquaman standalone.
Yes.
They will then come back together, because this is how many years of that's going to be, whatever, and then you're going to have Lex, and he will be the ultimate bad guy, and he's the one that they're all trying to stop.
It makes a lot of sense that it will go that way.
Yeah.
It's just, I have to see it.
Yeah.
It's one of those things that I've said it from the start. Like,
yeah.
There was that one picture that came out of Jesse Eisenberg when he did shave his head.
And it looked awesome.
It looked perfect, it right?
Was, yeah.
I can't deny that. But yeah. when they bring out a trailer and yeah. they show him with the whole, like...
Yeah, but...
He's got like Mickey Mouse, like, I'm sort of like, I don't like this tone. I'm like, you're going for this really dark tone.
Yeah.
And to throw that in there, do you know what it feels like? A Michael Bay film, where this... unneeded, unwanted, stupid humor is thrown into it. Where I'm like, no. You want a dark tone.
Yeah, they... I don't know. I disagree a little bit. I love the tone that they're going through because he at the moment, he is young.
Yeah.
There's no denying that. I'm thinking it's just Lex as a young kid
yeah.
becoming into the role. Now, what does he already know? He knows... He has smart-ass remarks that already leads to him knowing that Clark is Supes.
Yeah.
I believe he already has remarks that kind of hints towards him knowing that Bruce Wayne is Batman.
Right.
And he is poking fun at them in that scene without them enough to give that away. You know what I mean?
This is the only thing I'm curious about. I'm not going to be upset about this because yeah. something could come of it.
Yeah.
But you've got, he has the knowledge of kryptonite.
Yes.
You see him with the glasses.
He does have, yeah.
Right. He somehow has the knowledge and the technology.
Yeah.
To what it seems to be, take the body of Zod.
Yes.
And
Zod, yes.
And
yeah.
create Doomsday.
Yes. Right? And yeah, you can put it together that Zod will be Doomsday.
Right, yeah. And we sort of go... And pretty much... what's the actor's name? That played Zod. Pretty yeah. well confirmed...
The weird-looking
yeah,
dude.
Yeah. He's cool.
He's cool.
But pretty much confirmed that, yeah, he's... back in the film, not back in the film. Yeah. So
he's back as the body, but I think he'll voice
yeah.
he'll voice Doomsday.
But
we'll see.
But this is the thing, right? All they needed, right,
mm-hmm.
at the end of that trailer was the roar. And when I first watched the trailer and I heard the roar, I was waiting for just the title to pop up, and I'm like, so that's that way. It's like everyone knows what it is. Everyone knew. Everyone already had their suspicion. Yeah. But to throw it out there like that.
No, because that is him coming, like, when do you think that is? I reckon that's going to be 3/4 into the movie.
And I think it might even be half.
Because they only met Wonder Woman.
Yeah, but also, Batman's attire. He is,
yeah.
So you see Batman, I reckon there might be 3 fights with Batman versus Superman, right?
Yeah.
Because you see Batman where he's just in his regular...
Bat clothes.
Yeah, bat clothes.
Bat
yeah.
clothes.
Right, then yeah. you've got his armor.
Yeah, armor clothes.
Yep. And then yeah. at the end when he's got...
the blue Batman suit from the cartoon series.
Is it blue?
No, I'm just fucking with it.
Yeah, you yeah. can because...
It would have been cool though.
It's the colorblindness. Yeah. So I'm like, is it blue?
Yeah.
I'm like, but no, literally...
The cameo from Adam West in there is going to be amazing. There is no Adam. I see, I'm just staring you now.
Yeah, I know.
I just love it.
You're gonna rage me.
I wish there wasn't. That would be cool.
Yeah, it'd be like the sort of the Stan Lee, like...
Yeah, and they should do that for this one. Adam West, that's it. I'm going to sign a petition. I want Adam West doing a Batman dance in a club.
Yeah, like that. Like just in the background somewhere.
Like that.
In a Gotham club. They can, yeah. just, they can
put that in.
But yeah, at the very end of the trailer, it shows Batman again in yeah. his regular getup.
Yeah.
So that's why I'm sort of like, well, I don't know where it's going to go in, but it's going to be something different.
It's going to be cool.
I feel after those two fighting with Doomsday, as if they're going to throw down with each other again.
They're not going to after that. I think they're going to not get along, but that's what's going to be really good about it.
Yeah.
So, we'll see. Time will tell. That's Bats and Supes. Let's push that to one side. The one question I want to ask you, with all these other superhero movies coming out, we've got Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, the sequel, with Bebop and Rocksteady.
Oh my god, that looks yeah. incredible.
It looks very fun.
Yeah, and that's exactly what it should be. It's there's so much Turtle stuff coming out now.
Yeah.
You got a new Turtles game coming out that yes. comes out this year.
Yep, yeah.
As well as the movie as well. So...
2 Turtle things coming out.
Well, you've already got the series.
Yeah, yeah, right? cartoon. Yeah.
As well as the new comic that just came out.
Yep.
You've got the Batman and Ninja Turtles comic.
Which is, I think, ridiculous.
It is anyway. Absolutely ridiculous. I bought the first issue just because I'm like, I want to
see what this is like.
Yeah. It's good for a laugh. But yeah, the Turtles are really being revamped. And to bring them back in the second film, bringing back Bebop and Rocksteady.
Yeah.
What a way to go. Like, yeah. you sort of like, good on you, movie studio, for doing something that everyone actually wanted for a change.
What just annoys me that Seamus... is not going to be Seamus for very long in the movie. I reckon less than 5 minutes, and then he'll just be the voice.
Well, yeah, that, but we sort of expected that.
Yeah, I would have liked them to have that big lead up before they turn into it. I think they're going to turn into... I think the opening scene is pretty much going to be them turning into it, and then the whole movie is going to be just them fighting.
As well as Tyler Perry as Baxter Stockman.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm like, interesting choice, but I like it.
You like it? And, so, and our Casey Jones.
That's a really...
Stephen Amell. Yeah. Who I reckon that's how he got into the wrestling, because Sheamus and... Because
Sense.
Stardust.
All goes hand in hand.
Okay, so that is Ninja Turtles. You got Doctor Strange with Cumberbatch.
Yeah, which there isn't a trailer for it yet.
There's just some stills.
Yeah,
some stills. Cool. Looks cool. What other superhero ones have you got coming?
All right, so we've got the other one that dropped was we've got Suicide Squad. DC.
Oh my God, Harley Quinn is hot. That's all I care about.
They've overdone it a little bit.
No, they haven't.
Right?
They've hit the tone right. Well done.
They have.
Well done.
They have,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
But...
that new trailer with Will Smith talking about friggin'...
Maybe this is the... worst of the worst. Maybe this is the unmanly in me.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
But to dress her like that...
Oh my God. Right? Yeah. Yeah.
And then just to like... you know,
second legs.
Yeah, and then just have her bend over on that angle to pick up that handbag at the end of the trailer. I'm like, straight up mainstream. I'm sort of like... it's just a little bit too much. I get she's a sex symbol, right?
She's a sex symbol, yeah.
There is more to her character than that. I don't know.
I think they're going to go there with this.
And I think they will.
I think that's one little bit to get the guys going, ooh, dog, that looks good. Sorry, I don't know why I'd talk like that. But I'm keen. I think it's going to be awesome. I think the action's going to be insane.
Yeah.
They've got a massive cast.
But just, I just want to mention the trailer. Whoever put this trailer together...
yeah.
Huge kudos to them.
Well done.
To take, like, you've got all these trailers that are coming out. They've got all these cool rock songs to them and stuff like that. And then you have the Suicide trailer, like, coming out. You're like, you know what? We'll do Queen.
Yeah.
Right? Bohemian Rhapsody straight through. And I'm like, what a wicked way to do it. And you never see it enough in trailers, but when you do, it's incredibly eye-pleasing.
Yeah.
About when they mix heavy hits with heavy beats.
Oh, where she's doo-doo-doo, pretending to shoot people with the gun.
And when they're doing that, no, and they're like every hit just lands with it.
It's good.
So good, and it makes the trailer look so good. As also, just all the little nods in there, right?
Yeah.
Like with Joker falling into the vats.
Yes.
I'm like...
because that was the first indication... that it's not the Harley Quinn. There's two Harley Quinns in the comic book. Well, there's probably three. But there's two Harley Quinns in the comic book franchise. This is not the Harley Quinn that was the therapist.
The Harley Quinzel.
The Harley Quinn. Yeah, that's right. So this is... they've pretty much given that away. This is the one where the Joker forms her. Which some people are really pissed off about.
We'll see, like, you know, again, this is one of those things where if you take something and go, we're going to change it. Which is all right, because the cool thing is, yeah, he falls into vats. We don't know what the chemical is.
I think it's good. You know why I think this is good?
You might be saying what I'm about to say.
No, go for it. No, I was going to say the reason why I think this is so cool is because if it is the Robin story that I hope it's going to be, Batman made Robin...
Yeah.
And pretty much, you know what I mean? And then the Joker turned Robin into the Joker.
Yeah.
So to speak. So now he's turning Harley Quinn into Harley Quinn.
That was one thing. Yeah, one thing I was going to mention as well. But also, if he is falling into the vats, right?
Yeah.
And what is one thing, like, what is the one thing that everyone hates about the Jared Leto Joker?
The tattoos.
Right.
Yeah.
Now, if you fall into a chemical vat that's going to bleach your skin, perhaps,
yes.
What's the first thing that's going to go?
Your hair.
Well, that too, because
but
also, like,
you
could strip him of the tattoos.
Nah, he's not going to.
I don't think it's going to, and I think, I never had a real issue with the tattoos. No. I haven't from the beginning. Maybe damaged on the forehead.
Yeah.
But from what I'm seeing...
he's going to be a very intense Joker.
Yeah, and I like that. Hmm. Down to the laugh, where he's laying in the circle with all the knives and guns around him, I'm like, that is a really...
forms a question mark or something, I think, doesn't it?
Yeah. Is it?
I think so. I think it's a symbol. I'll double check.
I'll have to look at that one.
Okay, what other movies that are coming out?
All right, so on that one, that's all that DC stuff. But Marvel dropped one as well.
Yes.
Right?
Civil War.
So now...
Iron Man versus Caps.
Now this is...
Team Iron Man?
Nah.
Team Caps?
Yeah, I'm Team Caps.
Team Iron Man.
Yeah, I like the whole Rebel side of things. Now... Civil War has been my favorite story arc since Marvel story arc since it ever came out.
Since he hit the hearse.
Yep.
Yeah.
So, what?
Favorite story arc? Come on, that's going to be pretty cool. Your life, you got hit, accident.
I mean,
your own story arc.
Not my story arc. No, story.
Yeah, I understand. I'm just saying in your life.
Right.
That was your best
story arc.
Right. I don't know. Continue.
I think I have better ones.
All right. Sorry, my bad. Continue. Civil War is the best story arc.
Right?
Yeah.
And they have changed a lot in the film. Because obviously when you bring Civil War together, in the actual book itself, they have hundreds of like heroes, villains, the whole lot coming into it.
Yeah.
But now it's going to be... obviously they've toned it back.
Yeah.
And it's going to be that core story. But I'm curious which way they're going to go.
Yeah.
Now, I'm not going to give any spoilers away for the book. A lot of people who have read Civil War, they know how it ends.
Yes.
Right? It ends pretty horrifically for a whole bunch of people.
No spoilers.
No spoilers. But I'm curious on which way it's going to go. As well as, not so much a spoiler, but yes, Spider-Man is in it.
And they did not show him.
They're not showing him whatsoever. And I don't know if that's because they haven't... fully push the rights across yet to show him if they haven't got the costume down right.
If he's in the movie, they can show him. They've got the rights. I think they're just not doing it. There'll be another big trailer just before it comes out and they will show him right at the end of that trailer.
Yeah, and it'll be something like that. Yeah. But the one thing I really, really want to see, and I have a gut that I'm not going to see it, is the Iron Spider. Right?
You may. We'll see.
So anyone who knows the Iron Spider, Tony Stark is like, hip, we'll boot you a suit.
Yeah.
It's being used more often than not now. It comes up in the Ultimate Spider-Man series as well.
Yeah.
But a wicked suit. I don't know if we're going to see it.
I don't think so.
Just for the way it's going as well.
Yeah.
But do you reckon we'll see Punisher? Punisher plays a big part in Civil War.
You know why I don't think we'll see the Punisher?
Because it's still in Daredevil.
Yeah, and they're gonna that's their ticket for like Daredevil is good on its own.
Yeah.
But this is to bring in that more population. I think Daredevil. Punisher is in Daredevil season 2 is the Batman versus Superman story.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like they're doing that on TV.
Yeah, and their TV stuff is wicked. Like DC's TV stuff is wicked. Marvel's TV stuff is wicked as well. Yeah. They do really
well. They keep their own tone. But what I wanted to talk about, because now we've just gone through all the trailers.
Yes.
Majority of the episode talking about the trailers. Will superhero movies ever drop off?
Yes.
Like, you think they will?
Yes, absolutely. And I think they already have started to do that.
You think they're turning... I think they're just, like, building. I don't think... if they keep releasing superhero movies, I'll keep going to the cinema.
Yeah, no, I didn't say that I won't.
No, but...
The quality... I reckon the quality sort
you
of...
You think they're pumping them out too quick now? They're rushing.
Yeah, and that's why I feel like... It's almost like a Call of Duty game now. I'm like... Yeah. I used to love Call of Duty. I'm like, yeah, cool, World War II. And then they're like, yep, modern. I'm like, that's something different.
Yeah.
And now they're like... Modern, future, like space, like, and every year, like, exosuit, bam, bam,
exosuit,
bam,
exosuit.
Yeah, and I'm like, I've lost it now. Like, and if they keep doing that, and they could do it with Star Wars as well, they could kill it.
Yeah.
Right? That you're kind of like, yeah, cool, we're expecting it now. So obviously, when Force Awakens comes out, and it's been X amount of years, you're like, woo, Star Wars, right?
Yeah.
But then when like,
it's every year there's something else,
you're like, oh, yeah, we'll see Star Wars when it comes out.
Nah, see, as long as they keep putting the effort... Like, in saying that, I know where you're going, because to me, even Avengers 2 wasn't as good as the first one, because it felt like you'd seen it before.
No, that was... and someone else used this expression the other day, saying that things have a Age of Ultron curse now. Like, it's like, cool, you love the first Avengers, because when you saw them all together, you're like, that's great. And you'll have that when you see Justice League as well, right?
Yeah.
Like, when you see Dawn of Justice and they're all together at the end, you'd be like, yes, that's what we wanted to see.
Yeah.
But when they finally release a Justice League movie, like, that's what I expect, so... Will the tone drop?
No. I think DC, they are rebooting their franchise, and this is the perfect platform. They are getting it right from the get-go. As much as a lot of people didn't like Man of Steel, I thought it was awesome. I
like Man of Steel.
Yeah, but a lot of people didn't. A lot of people don't like Zack Snyder.
And really?
A lot of people don't. My brother thinks The Watchmen is like one of the worst movies ever. And I thought the exact opposite. I think The Watchmen is one of the best movies
ever done. Honestly, Watchmen to this date is still my favourite superhero film.
And you know why? Because it's the tone. It's made for adults.
Yeah.
The effects are amazing.
The storyline's perfect as well.
But that's what I mean. They don't rely on the action to take away from that. You take the action out of The Watchmen, and it's still a grade A movie.
No, it's amazing. It's such a good film.
In fact, there's not much action in it when you think about it.
No, there isn't. And like they add all this extra stuff in, which makes it really cool.
Yeah.
So, even the ending, it's got such a cool, meaningful ending. I'm like, wow! Like, nothing else could pull that off.
So, recapping, you feel as long as they don't rush it, the movies will always be big. We are only seeing the start of a very long period of superhero movies.
They can save this, right?
They can.
And Marvel almost did it, right?
Yeah.
And DC are doing it now. But what I think they need, I reckon, I'm going to say need, not just want, but they need this,
yeah,
is more villain arcs. More of these villain storylines.
That will come in and do one bit for this movie and then go do another one.
So Marvel almost did Sinister Six.
Yes.
And then they're like, well, we're moving on.
Yeah.
Now, obviously, DC has done Suicide Squad.
Yeah.
Really different tone, but all in the same universe. And, yes, we're going to see Batfleck in Suicide Squad.
And his own trilogy, I believe.
Yeah, yeah. But yeah. I'm just saying it, seeing him in Suicide Squad.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
It's cool to have them. And, like, you know how you normally, like, you'd have your hero films. You're like, cool, we get just little bits of villains here. Like, oh, yeah, that villain's over there. You'd get, like, that
he's
little
doing, yeah.
Now it's going to be the opposite. We're going to, like, get the glimpses of our heroes in these villain films.
Yeah, okay. I'm with you.
And if it's done right, I reckon it's going to be done really well. I reckon it's cool.
Awesome. Well, I guess, guys, we should start wrapping this up.
Mm.
Hope you enjoyed the intro as well. Obviously, we just want to let you guys know, for the people watching us on YouTube, we can't actually have that intro. We can't do that in one take.
Well, no.
No, so that's why you just had the logo, why you heard the intro. Hope you loved it anyway. Let's just do a quick recap of all the sites that people can actually come under the May Contain Hub now.
Yeah,
okay. Like
I said, family's growing.
So first of all, the bread and butter, the staples, the link's going to be below, www.podomatic.com. www.maycontain.podomatic.com.
Mm-hmm.
My bad.
That helps.
Basically, look us up, follow, subscribe us, and share us on that.
Yes.
You also have us on YouTube.
Yeah.
Okay, so it's just YouTube/C/maycontain. I believe, or just literally just look up in the search bar, May Contain the Slap.
It's the easiest way to find it.
Yeah, you'll find us in there. What other ones we've got? We've got Redbubble now.
We've got Redbubble, so buy all our merchandise, so you get like shirts like this. You can get sweatshirts, I've looked. You've got the jumper up there. You don't get the gas mask, I'm sorry.
You don't get it. Yeah, that's not for sale yet. Not yet.
But yeah, we have Redbubble. We still have our Facebook.
Yes, yes. So just jump onto our Facebook page. That's going to be, obviously, a lot of yous are, but please get your friends to jump on there and share and support us. And obviously, we are accepting more sponsorships, because this episode right now is sponsored by The Odd Leaf.
Did you really have to look at that?
I've
got it up here. It's
yeah?
The Odd Leaf. Come on.
My bad.
I'm a fan. So, like, it's one of these, and also we still got our Twitter as well, so @may_contain.
God, I don't know the show.
Yeah. I'm supporting The Odd Leaf so much that I don't know the show anymore.
Damn you! But guys, please jump over and check them out, because they are really good at their blogs. It is awesome to see another local group getting together and doing non-mainstream game reviews, board games. They're going to get into comics, I believe,
yeah,
and you know, movies and things like that later on. But jump over, give them a little tick. We'll post a link on our Facebook page as well to support them. So get on over, and once again, let us know what you want to see.
That's it. So obviously, like, give us the topics, give us the challenge. Challenges now.
Challenge.
Keep the show going. If you want to hear something or hear our opinion on something, or just hear me rage about something, drop us a line. And then you've got Facebook, Twitter, all those.
Yeah.
Any of those to drop us a line. So.
Okay, guys, take it easy. Good luck. I just got to go see our third member, who's sitting right over there now, because we are about to work on our game capture card.
Mm-hmm.
Hmm. Hint. So take it easy. I gotta run. You can say goodbye to everyone. I gotta go, guys. See you later.
So I'm Sopes.
I'm Gander.
And we'll see you next time. Thanks, guys.